welcome back to the second episode of Mole Ninja. Last time we left off as our wonderful Gecko 45, the hero that he is, saved the life and the virginity of the mayor's nephew. Continued.
But when our king saved the life and possibly the virginity of the mayor's nephew, there was a special relaxation of the rules made for us, due to the fact that your nephew, who will remain nameless to prevent a scandal, was saved by us using weapons better than our issue setup. So now we have good funding for gear for our jobs, and we needed to find reliable SMGs. But the HKs just wouldn't cut it.
Yep, kids, this is where it gets fun. You've been warned, comments the archivist. posted by Infantry 556. Hello, Gecko 45, or should I say, Mole Ninja! Just some real quick advice. Stay away from special weapons. To call them shit would be too nice. Also, save the mayor's nephew? Is that some kind of fucking joke? Gecko 45 writes,
it was a hostage situation that was hushed up. The SWAT pretty boys were overpowered by the gap. And we back up RTFers had to resume our roles and basically put everything 5x5. The takedown was actually applied by the SW weapons, SW3s. It happened a while ago, and there is no way you would know what city I am in, so I can reveal these details. Let's just say that the mayor had really deep pockets to keep all this out of the news. People aren't so holy and upstanding when you get out your checkbook. They start to forget stuff. At least, that what I understood happened. By the way, all these mispronunciations of words, those are his typos that I'm reading as they appear. And then the archivist comments, at this point, I should mention that I have taken no responsibility for coffee or other fluids that may be ejected from your nostrils onto your keyboard. This was when a second poster, Spec Ops, chimed in, and then things just got even stranger. Spec Ops writes, listen, I don't expect you civilians to understand the situation. Okay, pause the video.
And we're back.
Spec Ops writes, what kind of words can I apply to this asshole? I can't use the same one.
Listen. I don't expect you civilians to understand the situation, but bear with me and I'll see if I can pound it into your soft skulls. With the decay of society and the rotting away of the moral fiber of our country, this world is getting more and more dangerous and downright mean. Who do you think protects you from the scum of this society? The cops? The FBI? The army? This again, it's the guys guarding your companies, your banks, your schools, your homes, your supermarkets, and yes, smartass, even your malls. What good are the cops going to be if a shooter shows up at your workplace? How about your kid's school? Remember Columbine? I'll tell you what the cops will do. Call the SWAT team and screw around trying to locate the front door for 30 minutes while you or your children are shot down like prairie dogs at a drunken machine gun shoot. We are on site when the cops are cruising around handing out speeding tickets and harassing prostitutes. We risk our lives so you can go home to mommy at the end of the day, and this is the respect we get? Hell, I'd call some of us heroes, but I'm sure most of you juveniles don't understand the meaning of such distinguished word. So go play Rainbow Six and frang some tangos, and tell your mommy to bring you some milk and cookies. Meanwhile, my ass is on the line so your fat butt can go to the mall and pick up the latest copy of Computer Gaming Monthly without getting jumped and sodomized in the mall bathroom.
Oh my god. Go on. Okay, hold on. We need to get a different game here. Doom 2, okay, we're past Doom. There's no more mall stuff in here, unfortunately. So, we'll be right back. And we're back! And we got Duke Nukem here with Zombie Mall.
And before I was rudely interrupted...
Stay safe, Gecko 45. I got your back, brother.
And then the archivist comments, "Great, now he's got a friend. At least Spec Ops understands the value of paragraphs." And then Gecko45 writes, "We only patrol the roof, maintenance areas, and parking lots with rifles. MP5 for if TSHTF indoors. And Glock 30s on our belts. The MP5 is carried discreetly under the seats of the electric transportation car, and we only wear BDUs. It's not extreme to be prepared, and the merchants don't mind. It keeps the neo-Nazi gangs and the Crips out of the mall. We did have a situation, but such things are easily disguised as, say, an evacuation due to a gas leak at one of the restaurants, and the operation of both sides was so well contained that they almost got away with it, and we just managed to bring it to a halt. This is not a fantasy. It's my job. And if it's too harsh of a reality for your armchair commandos, then get another beer and change websites, because this is a real world of CQB. I can hack it. Can you? I do not think so. And your attempt to make fun of me is lame and childish." The archivist comments, "At this point, they start encouraging each other. Bear in mind, the derogatory posts from the other members are flying around like shrapnel from an Abercrombie and Fitch store window being prepped with 223 rounds. Peppered with 223 rounds. And then, somebody called Nordic posts, "Oh, and the other part about you and your team on patrol around the mall with G36s, I'm sure the local merchants association just loves people in body armor carrying assault rifles in front of their shops. That must really bring in the business. Here's a tip for you. Why don't you unplug yourself from your Nintendo?" You can tell that this shit is ancient. "Why don't you unplug yourself from your Nintendo, throw out those comic books, and spend your time fantasizing about girls like most other 13-year-old boys?" Spec Ops writes, "Nordic, pull your thumb out of your butt and listen to me. We are here to protect 13-year-old boys like yourself, so you don't get gang raped behind the dumpster outside the mall arcade on your way home to mommy after killing some bad guys at the Silent Scope game." Silent Scope, it's a game, an old one. I just can't remember anything about it.
Oh, I remember that. Okay, I get it.
"By the way, we aren't seen by the customers. We are low profile and only spring into action when we are needed. Even when we are working, you will rarely see us drop the perp and take him in for questioning. We work fast and avoid publicity. By the way, I don't use the plastic piece of shit HK. My team uses Colt R0933s. That's a 223 Select Fire M4 Commando with an 11.5-inch BBL, for those of you who don't know shit about guns that aren't on Rainbow Six. We cut down the stocks and PGs M4A1K, helicrew style, so that we can conceal them when we are plain clothed. Other versions have KACRAS with forward grip, Trigicon Reflex LLs, Insight Tech Dot Tac lights, and visible lasers. Also have a couple 14.5-inch BBL with Trigicon ACOG TA-11 3.5x35s for longer-range work. Most of the kit selection is up to the individual operator and his specialties. Go back to your shoot-em-up games. Maybe you learned something. Remember, real life doesn't have a reset game option."
Okay, could you make heads or tails of all those letters and numbers?
Not even I could. it's just throwing out names and bullshit. It's like, my God. It's like, I think he doesn't even know what he's talking about. I think it's like, it sounds cool. It's like ACOG 3x...
Okay, so, remember when Spec Ops said, stay safe, Gecko45. I'll get your back, brother." Well, Gecko45 replies,
"You see, some people here understand the risks we security officers undergo to protect you people. Would we exist if our jobs were useless? I tell you that we are undervalued for our beneficial effects on society at large. For the urban and suburban shopping centers see 80% of the armed violence in this nation.
And why don't the cops secure it? Because they're a bunch of wusses, and they are not men enough to put up with this danger and stress. You all who are making fun of me have never been threatened by jail drug dealers, serial killers, and shoplifters, or fired at by high-powered rifles. So shoot me if I decided, to have good weapons to protect and defend myself without all of you making fun of my choice and the way I do my job.
Oh, man.
Drug dealers, serial killers, and worst of all, shoplifters.
Oh, I died.
And then some guy called Ike, E-K-I-E, writes, if anyone is interested in a super glamorous vocation such as a security officer or armored car messenger driver, I have positions available in southern Missouri. We are frequently in need of mall ninjas.
Oh, man. You want to know something that's kind of funny? Years and years ago, like a long ass time ago, my grandfather actually had to be a security guard for like a couple of years, at least until like Compaq. And, you know, he actually mentioned that a while back. At least I remember it, okay? He didn't even carry a gun, and it was mainly a job where he could read a book most of the time. You don't need a fucking high-powered rifles. What you need is a way to stay awake.
And then Gecko 45 responds, I'm not a ninja, merely a student of the art of ninjutsu. And I prefer not to have status such as ninja laid upon me. For as yet, I'm unworthy of the title. I'll be completing my ninjutsu training in a little over 8 months, and then I will be a master of ninjutsu. A true ninja. But it's not my martial arts skills that make me so vital to the security of the mall. It's my tactical and strategic skills honed by years of intense on-site, on-the-job training. My weapon skills are the envy of the squad, and I think that with my expertise, I should be able to choose an effective and reliable weapon for CQC and urban combat. Which is why I chose
combat in a mall.
Which is why I chose SW. The MP5s are junk, comparatively.
Really?
So some guy called HKZ says, so now you're posting as some ranting idiot that goes by Spec Ops, Todd? Spec Ops? What the hell is Rainbow Six, and how do you know so much about it? You can tell that this was like early in the 2000s, because people, even casuals by now, should at least have heard of Rainbow Six.
Yeah.
Anyways. Yeah?
I was going to say, although I haven't really played much of that game series, only Rainbow Six Vegas, which I thought was pretty good.
I never played it at all. Spec Ops writes, in response to HKZ, boy, who the hell is Todd? And who do you have such... And why do you have such a hard-on for the guy? No, I'm not this Todd character, and no, I won't put on a dress for you or pretend I'm your boyfriend, Todd. As for all this mall ninja crap, I can't speak for my brother in arms, Gecko 45, but I don't even work in a mall anymore. I work for an exclusive security company. A corporation. Yeah, corporation. That's why we get all the good C3 stuff. Read upon your NFA laws, you jacklegs. We get contracted out to do security and surveillance by other corporations that are high-risk locations or high-priority targets for terrorist corporation espionage, for terrorists, corporate espionage, criminals, gangs, etc. Yes, I have worked high-risk security at certain malls, and yes, the corporation I work for does do contract work for malls. That's why I know a lot about the topic. Of course, I work higher-profile assignments now. That's what 15 years experience, countless hours of training, 7 company citations, and 3 gunshot wounds, 5 knife wounds, and a lot of hard work will do for you. As far as the ninja stuff, yes, we train our people in some forms of martial arts, but nobody here considers themselves a ninja. Hey, HKZ, you better get back to the TV. I think it's time for Power Rangers to come on. Gecko 45 writes,
Spec Ops has his head screwed on straight, unlike the rest of you. I'm glad a guy like him won risk his life to serve in this high-risk profession. I know it's tough, but the responses from this from this board sure prove that most of you can do this job with help.
And then Nordic writes, ha 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 ha, oh please stop, you're killing me. Listen here, geek ops. You go right ahead and continue on with your little playtime fantasy. Myself and the others here have better things to do than listen to your little gun loop fantasy. If you want to sit behind your computer, safe in the knowledge that no one knows who you are, or that you still wear Superman underwear and continue your little ego farts, then more power to you. No one, and I mean no one here, believes a single word of what you're saying. So more intellect. Okay, can you hear me?
Yeah, you're back.
Okay. So we're all off to more intellectual stimulating topics and say goodbye to you and all your multiple personality disorders. Bye-bye. Spec Ops replies. Left on, laughing boy. You're just jealous that Spec Ops...
Did he actually say Spec the Ops... wrong name?
No, Spec Ops is talking about himself in the third person, or this could be Gecko 45. You know, it's great. I'll still say it like it's Spec Ops. You're just jealous that Spec Ops and I have something to show for our lives, and you do not. The corporation's work is the only thing I can talk about. Spec Ops may have led a more adventurous career. Yeah, this is fucking Gecko. But his actions must have been... that's great.
His actions must have been very above board for him to be able to discuss much of his work with you. My Black Ops history ensures that you will never know about the mission. That you'll never know about the missions I accepted in my younger days. And Vietnam still shudders when it hears the name of an assassin so skillful and deadly he is remembered decades later.
What?
Shall I read it in my normal voice, just in case you misheard? Okay.
I hope all of you managed to find some meaning in life, because you obviously have never put your life on the line for others, and until you have almost died, you have never lived. In my profession, you take risks that will be considered impossible to 99% of other men, and undergo pains that a mere shock of which would kill any three of you pansy weights. Spec Ops know what I mean. He's thin, I can tell, and you can take his word for it. It's harder than you think.
My god.
And then Rick 314 writes, dude, a lot of these people are too wrapped up in their own activities to stop and see that there are folks with guns keeping you and your safe. Hats off to you, retail security types. I feel better knowing well-trained security spec op types are there with quality weapons keeping a sharp eye out for me and mine. Thanks, you brave and beautiful people. How's that partner of yours that does the prone support for your tactical firing type positions? Do you use secure comms? Can the guys at Radio Shack tune into the real deal going on around them? You guys should get more money. Thankless damn job, in my humble opinion. To which Gecko 45 replies, thank you, Rick. It's nice to know that I have your support in this dark, cruel world. When not on solo ops, we do use secure communications devices. And no, you cannot get them at Radio Shack. Military frequencies are scrambled using a 256-bit encryption algorithm, and it is well nigh uncrackable in any reasonable amount of time. Just for those who have asked, I will not reveal my identity. Some of you know what I mean. So, Nordic said, Nordic said, no one, and I mean no one here, believes a single word of what you guys are saying, so we're all off to more intelligent conversations. Enjoy your DID, bye-bye. Spec Ops writes, you still here? I thought it was nap time in Mr. Rogers' neighborhood. Don't worry, just ignore this thread like a big boy, and you can get back to more intellectually stimulating topics like, what is the best Pokemon episode? Or, which Ultimate Twin do you prefer to whack off to? I could care less if you believe me. I've been through hell and back and lived to tell about it. So far, you've only lived through 7th grade. You have a lot to learn about the real world, and I'm not talking about the MTV show. God, this is ancient.
Yeah, it is.
Okay, so HKZ posts, for the love of God, why don't the moderators kill this thread? I've not seen this much stupidity my entire life. Spec Ops, you sure do make a lot of references to homosexuality. That is a telltale sign of someone who is not secure with their manhood. It is obvious that you lack any qualities that a real man may have. I pity you and your obviously pathetic existence. To which Spec Ops replies, Spec Ops, yeah, Nancy, cry to the mods to kill the truth. Just because you're too much of a Sally to hear real men talk about real life experiences. By the way, a one-time experimentation while in the military does not make one a homosexual.
What?
Yep. By the way, a one-time experimentation while in the military does not make one a homosexual. It's when you practice it daily, like yourself, that you become a homosexual. Don't worry, even though you don't believe me or my work, I'd still save your ass if you got into trouble in one of my secured areas. That's my job, and I practice it proudly. However, you come into the sector I'm LRRPing? Live rowdy roleplay?
I don't really know what that's supposed to mean. Just nod your head politely.
However, if you come into the sector I'm lurping with the intention of causing trouble, I'll break you into bite-sized, shrink-wrapped pieces so fast you'll be Rottweiler poo-poo before you even begin to feel the pain. Oh, God.
How much more is there?
we've barely reached the halfway mark.
Okay, we'll do one more level of Duke, actually.
Okay. So, HKZ posts, Spec Ops, you couldn't break one of the schoolgirls you stalk at your local elementary school, much less me. Not on your best day. I'm sure you're sitting on your overweight ass, typing at your PC, feeling really tough. It's amazing how tough one can be behind a computer screen. Keep it up with your threats if it makes you feel like a man. Luckily for you, you will never have to confront me face to face. You're nothing but a coward with a big mouth and a small brain. Then Spec Ops, in all his brilliance, replies, if 6'5" and 250 pounds is overweight, then so be it. Don't worry, Lucy. You'll never have to confront me as long as you stay on the right side of the law. And that's the government's law and my law. when you're on territory, I'm working. Until the day you cross that line, I'll keep watching over and protecting you. That's my job. The day you go bad is when you better watch out. That is also my job.
My God. Oh, yeah, I should probably turn no clip off.
And then Gecko 45 writes,
Calibers, I recognize the name. My squad and our organization's group of tech teams will be switching to SW shortly due to poor quality control and workmanship on HK's part.
You know what's funny? Hold on a second.
What?
Every time he blasts H and K, I actually get kind of incensed at that. It's like, who is this guy? You know? It's like, I actually would get it legitimately getting slightly pissed off at that guy constantly slamming them. Because I like HK. I'd have one if they were not so bloody expensive. But go on.
Actually, where did I leave off? Gecko, Porcelain.
My tech teams will be switching to SW shortly due to poor quality control and workmanship on HK's part. Spec Ops, I believe I know something of your identity since your last two posts. Were you ever aligned, if not part of, our nation's special forces? And for all of you who have a problem with real special operations guys, go try some of our work yourself. Run a mile in our boots before you judge our decisions. I personally applaud Spec Ops' decision to continue to protect and serve, despite your constant baiting and whining, because you're not as good as we are.
Spec Ops replies to that last comment.
Gecko, I'd rather not disclose my service record over the net among all these cities. No, I'm not an individual you... I'm not the individual... you believe me to be. However, I have a vigil in several operations elsewhere. I must say, I admire his work. He's a true hero. Who the fuck is he talking about? Jack Reacher? I only wish I could get him to work for my company. I believe we may have met at a seminar on entry tactics for the security specialist a few weeks ago.
Keep going.
And then the archivist comments, secret operators of the retail world unite. The love fest begins.
Okay, I got it. Okay, his real name is Bob Mullins and Bill Newcomb.
Are they real people or are you fucking with us?
No, it's a joke. It's like Duke Newcomb, you know, okay, Bill Newcomb. No, Bill Newcomb, that's his name. Bill Newcomb and Bob Mullins.
Yeah, but who's Bob Mullins?
Well, John Mullins was the player character in Soldier of Fortune.
Ah.
The 2000 FPS. So okay. It's Bob Mullins.
Okay. Let's see. This one was originally posted by a guy named Dr. HK.
Dr. Laugh HK?
Yes. Left my ass off. Real tough guy on the internet here. Listen, my feeble-minded friend, grow up and knock off the threats or take it somewhere else.
No.
So Spec Ops writes, Miss HK, there are no threats going on from my part. I'm only promising to do my job if I have to. Is it a threat when a police officer tells a criminal to stay straight? No. Similarly, it is not a threat to remind a person that he better not break the law on my ship. I don't claim to be a tough guy, but I have earned respect from my co-workers in a tough field. You guys are the ones that jumped on Gecko for wanting a good duty gun. Now, who are the tough guys behind the keyboards? When Spec Ops said, Gecko, I'd rather not disclose my service record over the net among all these civvies, Gecko45 responds, No, I'm not the individual. They forgot to quote all the rest of it. He's a true hero. I only wish I could get him to work for my company. Right, so Gecko45 writes, I understand your concern. I'm well acquainted with the operator in question, but you remind me vividly of him. An excellent seminar, by the way, which I enjoyed immensely, demonstrating to the instructor the proper procedure for breaching steel doorframes was a necessity. The man was a SEAL and a demolitions expert, but I couldn't just let him blow himself up. Too much C4, improper detonator, I could go on, but you know what I mean and what I did. What do you suppose is everyone's problem with a couple of real men who have put their lives on the line so many times for the good of the people, killed for their country, and they spit in our faces? I can begin to understand why they're not more grateful for our protection. Let's see. So, right. Spec Ops said, I don't claim to be a tough guy. You guys are the ones who jumped on Gecko for wanting a good duty gun. Where are the tough guys behind the keyboards? Gecko45 responds to that.
I agree wholeheartedly. Why must every remonstration to remain a law-abiding... Why must every remonstration to remain a law-abiding citizen so that we do not find it necessary to take you out be seen as a threat? If a kid picks up a candy bar and runs, you give him a warning before you cuff him. Same with those mindless teeny boppers who go to the Hickory Farm store and then take out double samples of fruitcake and cheese log. You warn them that they will be charged with a felony, grand theft, and that if they attempt to fight, and run, they will be unfortunately first tasered, and if they continue to resist violently, with intent to maim, then wounded.
For a cheese log? Really?
Remember, this guy's 400 pounds overweight. To him, taking away any amount of food is like killing Christ himself.
Fortunately, wounding fire to suppress teenage kleptomaniacs is relatively easy. They all run in straight lines, and a hit in the knee will be relatively simple from the second floor.
What?
But they all get a warning first. We do not simply shoot shoplifters unless they resist violently. Butt stroking? Oh my. Those who attempt to injure me is another story. Consider this your warning.
Nobody says that! Who talks like that? Butt stroking? just can't get over who butt stroking. Wow, holy shit!
I think you might want to explain this to some of the audience who don't know gun terminology.
There's such a thing called a vertical butt stroke, and I know what that sounds like, but what it basically means is you smack somebody upside the head with a rifle stock, and nobody ever calls it butt stroking.
It's like, okay, John, this is the plan, okay? We barge in, we butt stroke Ahmed and Muhammad.
Because they don't. And that's totally meant as a joke. Do not get offended. God damn it.
Okay, come on, John. We bust into that bunker and we butt stroke Hans and Gunther.
Okay, that's fine.
Because they're white and it's okay to make fun of white people.
Exactly.
Yeah. Where did I leave off? Oh, yeah.
Although, incidentally, hold on. One thing that Bill Newcomb here doesn't actually mention is that a vertical butt stroke has a good chance of killing whoever you vertical butt stroke if you hit them hard enough. But go on.
Consider this your warning, HK Sissy, because we'll aim for center if you get dangerous or violent on our patrol. You do not understand how difficult our job is, or you would be grateful for this warning you have been given. Whether you are on Spec Ops' turf or on mine, you will not repeat, not act up with iniquity.
And then Gecko45 continues to write,
I have come to the conclusion that most of you here, besides being insulting and rude, not to mention ugly, are ignorant. Why would you be defending a piece of shit like an MP5? Because in my experience, they just didn't work with hollow points. And anybody who would shoot full metal jackets in an urban area is also an idiot. I need to know how all of you experts can support a gun with so many FTFs and jams. Is this the acceptable performance you can't get because you are jealous of Todd and his business, which turns out quality firearms, and thus your bias against a salvageable gun is warping your judgments?
My god, the sentence construction.
This guy's an idiot. You gotta think like an idiot. He doesn't know how to write. I'm getting slightly pissed off every time he just completely disrespects the MP5. I don't even know why.
Well, to be fair, I'm not even going to bother joking. I actually used the MP5 in Far Cry 2, thus making me a specialist in it, so I know it's a good gun.
Well, I mean, it's like, see, here's the thing. The Far Cry gun. The Far Cry gun. My god. Bees. But anyway, the MP5 has actually been manufactured since, like, the 80s? Maybe late 70s? And, like, other more modern designs have been, you know, implemented, but it's popular for a reason. It works.
Anyways. What?
I was going to say go on. We're only going to do one more level of Duke, and then we'll just call it an episode, because it seems like there's a lot of stupidity going on here, and I can only take so much at any one time.
There is. Okay, so when Gecko45 wrote, I understand your concern. I'm well acquainted with the operator in question, but you reminded me vividly of him. Spec Ops replied to that with,
well, I did learn a lot from that particular operator. I studied his tactics in depth. In a way, you could call him my mentor. I enjoyed the seminar a lot, but didn't actually learn anything new and unique. Those young Suckum types just don't know what it's really like. As far as the heat we've been catching from these chairborne ranger types, I think it is for two reasons. First, they are jealous of our experiences, and that we get to actually use the guns that they beat off to nightly, pictures of the guns because they aren't old enough to own the real things. Second, they don't understand the dangers we are faced with every day protecting their asses. Like when I was working inventory loss prevention, We deal mostly against gang members and other assorted thugs. People don't realize the sort of gear these guys are packing. Gone are the days of gangbangers armed with chrome Lorsen 25s and Tech 9s. A lot of these kids are sporting Glocks in 10mm and 357 some USPs, SIGs, and an occasional Desert Eagle in 50 AE. Usually they're wearing... Really? Usually they're wearing at least level 11A concealable vests. Long arms range from AKs to AR-15s. The usual shotguns and some long-range stuff. Ran into one of them with a Ram 700P in 300 Witten mag with a loopholed MK4 sitting on top of it.
Okay, what the fuck does that last one even mean?
I think that's a scope.
Okay.
Some of these kids have been enlisting to get the military training and they go AWOL and teach the other punks what they've learned. Especially CQB and Moot. Moot? Mout?
Don't ask me. That could be real. I'm not sure.
Hell, I've run into a share of amateur gunsmiths. One kid had an SKS modified for FA and it was cut down to a Krinkov-like carbine length with a folding stock. Another had a REM 1100 modified to fire in FA and modified to accept a 20 RD drum from a USAS 12.
I think what he just described was functionally impossible.
Now that I work mainly in corporate security, you wouldn't believe the gear these corporate espionage types use. Temperature controlled level 4 studs to beat the heat sensors.
What?
PVS 14 goggles, MP5K and PDWs with KAC cans. I could go on about these guys. What the fuck is a KAC can?
I don't have any idea. And he actually just ended up contradicting himself. Why is he worried about the MP5? It's crap, right? Should that make him easier to kill, not harder? Oh my god.
Okay, one second. My throat is actually kind of... I'm not used to doing these voices, I'll be honest. I'm not fucking John DiMaggio who can, like, go on with deep voices or silly voices for a long time.
Outrageous!
Oh, God.
I like that show, goddammit.
Bite my shiny metal ass.
Okay, where?
I'll make a donkey out of metal.
Okay, never mind.
Anyways, a guy called Defy, D-E-F-I-I, writes, Gecko 45 and Spit... And Space Cop.
Space Cop.
I thought I had seen it all. So while you guys were telling your stories to each other, I walked to the house next door to get some answers. I brought an HK-91 along in case just to show it to him. Next door to me lives one of the owners of the mall giant Westcore. They own most malls and shopping centers in Arizona, including one at which there was a gang-related shooting inside the mall not too long ago. I explained why I was asking so many questions and told him the gist of this threat and it stood as it stood when I left my house. We discussed security and the arming of security guards. The guards at Westcore are hired by Westcore. They are allowed to carry handcuffs and mace. The senior shift officers carry an auto pistol. He was not sure of caliber. He then explained that there are no long guns allowed due to Westcore policy, especially not hidden under the seat of the golf cart.
I don't think it's a golf... I guess if this had been made recently... They'd have, like, the, what's that thing with the two wheels?
Ah, shit,
Segway!
Segway. That's even less dignified, goddamn. I then asked him if this would be allowed either on the roof or in the docks or anywhere on mall property. I opened my 9-1 and I thought he was going to shit his pants. He could not believe that I brought any such weapon... That I thought any such weapon would be allowed in a mall. I do not think he had ever seen the black rifle before. My point is to you, bow out gracefully. If such an exit is possible at this point, you do not use 308 caliber weapons to guard a mall. No way, no how. Sorry, game over. And then, Space Cop, Spec Ops, writes... Okay, when did I say I was located in Arizona or hired by Westcore? I'm not even technically employed by the mall. I'm stationed at my... I'm not even technically employed by the mall I'm stationed at. My orders come from higher up. Hint, hint. Sure. Sure, most regular overweight mall security guards would not be armed. they would lose a full-size frame handgun in the blubber of their waistline. Why arm them? The elite, however, have special privileges. And I can assure you that my orders go far, far enough that I could go around Kennedy Airport yelling, "Hijack!" and that a simple phone call and code word would have me released in 5 minutes. With my weapon, be what it may. As I said, my orders go far, and while my reasons for protecting this mall remain a matter of national security, if the above does not convince you that I'm employed in a capacity that goes above and beyond halting shoplifters, nothing will. By the way, my SW3 with 20RD thermal mag will continue to accompany my official actions under the eyes of shoppers as long as I am so assigned, and the fact that some West Dork security guard is scared of an HK-91 rifle is no proof that I do not use, carry, and train with one. Oh, God.
Okay, I think we're going to stop here. I think that's just a good stopping point.
Oh, God.
Because, damn, this guy's an idiot.
Oh, God, please, one more.
Oh, dear.
One more. Okay, so HKZ says, Spec Ops, 6'5". Wow, I did not know that crap could be stacked that high. And then Spec Ops replies, "You should know, you seem like the kind of guy that plays with your own feces. We have a name for guys like you in the industry, fecal freaks." One time I had to do a dynamic entry on one of the ladies' bathrooms because some freak had snuck in there and was trying to smear excrement on one of the lady patrons. You should have seen the look on his face when I pulled my Mark 23 on him. I think he made another little mess in his pants.
Okay. Okay, that don't that just beat all, ladies and gentlemen?
And there's still more!
So... now, I want to make a movie out of this. I really do want to make a movie out of this somehow. I mean, you can't make this shit up. I mean, this would make like... okay, see like... Paul Blart Mall Cop. And that other one with the guy, whose name I can't remember. The darker comedic one.
Chris Rock?
No. It was another guy. I can't... oh, what the fuck was his name? Observe and... Protect or something? Which? Observe and Report, that's the one. Those guys actually had more dignity than this guy. This would be... This needs to be a movie. This needs to be a movie. I would watch this. I would watch this a lot, because it would be just so funny. I don't know, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be back with more of this insanity later. But for now...
And just to make this official, I'm actually going to make a fucking title card for these fucking things. I'm a mall ninja on a Segway.
You got to have both of the guys on there. One looks like comic book guy, and the other... okay, Spec Ops the line needs to be comic book guy, and then... our illustrious lord needs to look... I don't know what he needs to look like, but he's looking...
our god, our guardian angel at the mall.
He's got to look like something, and there needs to be... The my god, this could be a video game, a beat-em-up video game. Because, like, doesn't Fecal Freak sound like a beat-em-up enemy?
He could be the fucking end boss.
I will defeat them all. Die, foul fecal freak.
Oh, God.
I think we need to give special thanks to the archivist who did that, because, man, this is some of the funniest shit I've ever heard.
Oh, shit. I don't even know who the fuck did this. I know this is on the website lonelymachines.org/mall-ninjas/.
I'll put a link in the description, but we're not done yet. It's about to get crazy.
We're not even fucking close.
All right, it's General Lotz.
And the M-Man.
Signing off.